this question is, in a group of students, 30% play only cricket, 20% play only football, and 10% play only basketball. 30% play only cricket. 20% play only football. And 10% play only basketball. 20% of the students play both football and cricket. 50% play both basketball and cricket. 10% play both football and basketball. And 15 students play no games. 15 play no games. Now, 5% of the students play all three games. 5% all three games. We'll subtract 5% from those which play only one, because out of this some are playing in this 5% also. Therefore, this will become 25. This will become, we subtract 5, this will become 15. We subtract 5, it will become 5. Now, this total will become 25, 15, 40 plus 5, 45. Now, two game players are 15%, 10% and 20%. 20%, 15% and 10%, this will become 45% again. This 245% will be 90%. When we add this 5% which play no game, play only one game, play two games and play all three games, we will have 95% students. If 95% are playing all games, 5% play no game. Now here it says that 15 play no games. 5% is equal to 15. 5% of total students is equal to 15. Therefore, x is equal to 15 multiplied by 100 divided by 5. That becomes 3 multiplied by 100 is equal to 300. Therefore, total number of students is 300. The problem said that 5 persons A, B, C, D and E are sitting in a row. 5 persons are sitting in a row. We'll analyze this problem. First position, second position, third position, fourth position and fifth position. And first condition is C in the middle. C in the middle. We'll have many different combinations. I will make around 6 combinations. Second condition says that D is at an extreme end. D is can be here. D can be, for second combination, D can be here. For third combination, D can be here. For fourth combination, D can be here. At the extreme end. There are at least 2 persons between B and E. 2 persons between B and E. B can be here. 1 person, 2 person, E. In say this combination also B can be here, 1 person, E. In third combination, B can be near D, E can be here. B can be here, E can be here. Now only one position is remaining. And that position can be filled by using A, A here, A here, A here. Another possibility, if we put E here and D here, B can be here, B can be here, D, here E, A will be here, A will be here. Okay. Now, this many combinations are available which fulfill that C is in middle. D is at extreme end in each, this is fulfilled. Between B and E, 2 persons shall be present. Between B and E, 2 persons are present everywhere in each combination. If all these combinations are possible. The first combination says that we have to find out, the question says that we have to find out which statement is incorrect. The first statement says that E can be on extreme left. E can be on extreme left. It's possible. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. E can be on extreme right. E can be on extreme right. This is also possible. This cannot be the correct answer. A cannot be on extreme left. A cannot be. In any combination, A is not on the extreme left. Therefore, this is not the one. A is always a neighbor of B or D. A is neighbor of B. Here, A is neighbor of B. Here, A is neighbor of E. But A is not neighbor of D here. It is neighbor of E. Therefore, this condition is wrong. Therefore, this fourth option is incorrect one. And this is the right choice. Now, this problem says that a sphere G of radius B. We'll draw a sphere. Sphere G with radius B is fixed mid-air and several spheres identical to the first one, identical to 2G, shot at it with their velocities parallel to each other. They are shot at G with their velocities parallel to each other. If the shot spheres fall within an imaginary cylinder of radius A, these spheres fall within an imaginary radius, imaginary cylinder of radius A. And A is very great, very bigger than B. Therefore, some portion will hit G. Then what fraction of spheres that will hit G? Then to hit G, the short sphere shall be within the radius G. Here also shall be within the radius G. Therefore, the cylinder or area through which the short spheres can hit G is will have radius 1B, 2B, 3B, 4B. When they fall within this radius only, then only they can hit the middle sphere. Therefore, it is radius is 1, 2, 3. To go beyond this, they will not hit. Therefore, that shall be radius 2B. When they fall within this radius 2B, then only they can hit this sphere. Spheres which are within this radius, within this area, only hit this G. Therefore, we'll calculate this area. This area is pi 2B square is equal to 4 pi B square. Then area of this through which the spheres are being shot is pi A square. And if you want to determine the proportion, then we will ratio or fraction, then we will have to divide this area with the larger area, pi a square. We will cancel out pi, the 4b square, our answer will be 4b square upon a square. And here is the answer, 4b square upon a square. The distance from Nehrunagar to Gandhinagar is 27 kilometer. Nehru Nagar to Gandhi Nagar, this distance is 27 km. A and B start walking from Nehru Nagar. A and B start walking from Nehru Nagar towards Gandhi Nagar at speed. Speed of A is 5 km per hour and speed of B is 7 km per hour. And they both return immediately. Both reach to Gandhinagar and return immediately. And meets A. B reaches Gandhinagar and returns immediately. Meets A at Indiranagar. Somewhere here, Indiranagar is located. The whole distance is 27 km. And Nehrunagar to Indiranagar distance is less than 27 km. When B starts walking at 27 km, within 3 hours, he will reach 21 km 3 hours you will reach 21 kilometer. Fourth hour he will reach 6 kilometer and 7 kilometer again, or he will reach Gandhinagar and then will return 1 kilometer. Then this means that he will be away from Nehru Nagar by a distance of 26 kilometer. He will be somewhere here between 1 kilometer away from Gandhinagar and 26 kilometer away from Nehru Nagar. And when A starts walking, within this 4 hour period, he will walk 20 kilometers somewhere here. Here B is present at after 4 hours. Here A is present after 4 hours. Within 5th hour, both will meet. Within 5th hour, B will travel some time and A will travel some distance and A will travel some distance, and they will meet at Indira Nagar. Therefore, the distance at which they meet from Nehru Nagar will be between 20 and 26 kilometers. And in these 4 options, only one distance is between 20 and 26 kilometers, that is 22.5 kilometers. Therefore, this is our answer. A leaf appears green in daylight. If this leaf were observed in red light, what color would it appear to have? This is question about color perception. Green leaf absorb light and give out green only. Absorbs all other wavelengths and give out green only. If we observe this leaf in red light, when red light falls on this leaf, it's green leaf, only red light is falling, and leaf can absorb all other wavelengths other than green. Green is not present here, therefore no green is there to reflect out. If no green is there to reflect out, no light will come out of the green leaf or of chlorophyll. Therefore this leaf will appear black, and only one option is here that says black, that is second option. Therefore this is our correct option, that chlorophyll absorbs all other light, will absorb the green light, and will absorb, not green light, will absorb the red light and will appear black in red light. This question asks for how much blood flows per day through a normal human heart beating 70 times per minute, having a relaxed volume of 100 cc and compressed volume of 70 cc. It says that within one beat, its volume changes from 100 cc to 70 cc, that means 40 cc or 40 ml blood is ejected out each beat. 40 ml volume of blood flows through heart in one beat. In 1 minute, 70 beats are there. In 1 hour, 60 multiplied by 70 beats are there. And in one day, 24 hours are there. Therefore, 24 into 60 into 70 beats will be there in one day. If you multiply this, this will become 4200 multiplied by 24. 00, 24 2s are 48, 24 4s are 96 plus 4, that's become 100. 100 or 1,800,000 beats per day are there in heart. And if these beats are ejecting out 40 ml volume per beat, 40 ml. Now this 20, 103, 1230, 4 8s are 32, 4 0s are 0, 4 1s are 4. This much ml blood will be ejected out through whole day, one day. If we convert this to liter, we'll have 4032 liter per day blood which flows through heart. And it asks approximately how much blood flows, approximately 4000 liters blood. 4032 approximates to 4000 liters. This much blood flows through heart per day. This question is the molar fraction of hydrochloric acid in an extremely dilute aqueous solution is doubled. Molar fraction is doubled in dilute aqueous solution. The pH of the resulting solution is, if we double the hydrochloric acid concentration, we double the H plus concentration, and because of this doubling of H plus concentration, pH has to reduce. we'll scan all these four approximately doubled. This says that pH is increasing, but by addition of H plus pH shall not increase. This is not the option. And again, this is not the option. Out of these two, approximately how? What we know that pH is minus log to the base 10 of H plus concentration. And we have doubled the H plus. Now this H plus concentration is 2, double the H plus. Log 10 of 2 is not double the log 10 of 1. Therefore, approximately halved by addition of H plus, this log will not get halved or will not get doubled. Therefore, this is not the answer. Only reduced remains there. By addition of H plus, pH will get reduced. This is the correct option. This question is the bar chart below shows number of seats won by four political parties A, B, C and D. Which party won the largest proportion of seats it contested? And black, this region, whole this region is seats won, and this white region is seats lost. Now it asks for proportion of seats, proportion of this total to the proportion of black. Now in this proportion of total will be more than half, here again more, next white area is slightly comparable to this one, this one. It visually appears that this is the largest proportion because very small of white area remains there and more area is of black. Therefore, B is the correct option, is the largest one. It can be verified visibly that this fraction is the largest fraction. Now this question, look carefully, it has four number combinations of number are there. One combination is 17, 15, 8, 13, 12, 5, 25, 24, 7, and fourth combination is 41, 40, and last is question, question mark, we have to find out which number fits here. Now these are three numbers in each combination. It says that it's a triplet. And it arranged in particular manner so that it forms a right angle triangle. Right angle being here. And 17, 15, 8, 8 square 64, 5, 15 square 225. If we add this, it becomes 4 plus 5, 9, 8, 289. 289 is square of 17. Therefore, this is a Pythagorean triplet. A square plus B square is equal to C square. 15 square plus 8 square is equal to 17 square, as we have seen. Here also, 12 square is 144, 5 square is 25, both will add to 169. This is square of 13. This is also Pythagorean triplet. Here also square of 24 is 576, square of 7 is 49, and both will add to 625, that is the square of 25. This is also Pythagorean triplet. To make this as Pythagorean triplet, 41 square is 41 is 9 less than 50. If we subtract 25, 9 from 25, we will get 16, and a square of 9 is 1681. And this 1681, if we minus square of 440 from it, we'll get 81. 81 is square of 9. Therefore, here number 9 fits, and therefore second option is the correct one. Question is, when Ramesh was of the age of 8 years, he hammered a nail into a large tree to mark his height. Ramesh compared his height while standing by the tree trunk and hammered a nail to mark his own height. Nail at this position. This is a large tree, grown up tree. If the tree grows 2 cm per year, how much higher would the nail be after 5 years? This is the grown up tree, therefore stem will not grow, only the branches will grow, growth will be on the higher part of the tree and lower part will not grow. Therefore this nail will not move up. Therefore, 5 cm higher is wrong option, 10 cm higher wrong option, 8 cm higher wrong option. Nail will remain at the position because tree has grown up, stem will not grow, and second option is the correct one. Now, this is for visual comparison of the images, and we have to find out the next pattern in the following sequence. This arrow goes down, here arrow goes up, here arrow goes down. Therefore, in the next one, arrow shall go up. In these three figures, arrow is up. Now here, one dot is there. Here two dots are there. Number of dots is getting doubled. Here two dots are there. In the next one, on the this corner, four dots shall be there. Four dot, one, one. In only one figure, four dots are there. Therefore, this can be our candidate figure. We'll confirm three triangles in a circle. Now this gets separated in second figure. Circle get entrapped into triangle. Three triangles entrapped in three circles. Here four squares are there in the triangle. Therefore, this will change to four triangles within four squares. Three triangles are there. Three triangles in three squares. Then this is the correct figure, correct option in the. For which of the following numbers is its positive square root closest to the number itself? And the four numbers given are 0.33, 0.99, 0.89, 0.10. This approach was wrong. Now I'll go by second approach. All these numbers, 0.33, 0.99, 0.89, 0.10, square root of 1 is 1. Therefore, square root of number close to 1, 0.99, will be close to 1 again, will be approximately 1 again. Then 0.99 square root, if it is near 1, then it's the number that square root of 0.99 is equal to itself. Therefore, this is the correct answer, 0.99. And we can confirm it by determining the square root of 0.99, we have to add 2 zero here, then first whole square is 81 near to 99, therefore 9 9 9s are 81, that will be 0.9 0.9, 0.81, then 0.18, 20 will import, then we'll add 0.9 here, we'll get 1.8, and 1.8 multiply that by 9, 1.89 multiplied by 0.09, 9 9s are 81, 9 8s are 72 plus 8, 80, 9 1s are 9 plus 8, 17, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 0.1701, therefore it will become 99 again. And this sequence will go on continuing. Therefore, it is confirmed that square root of 0.99 is most close to itself only, or most close to 0.99 only. Therefore, this answer is confirmed. This question says that there are two gas parcels of equal volume A and B at the same temperature and pressure. Parcel A is 1 mole of water vapor. Parcel A is 1 mole of H2O. And parcel B is 1 mole of dry air. Parcel B is 1 mole of air. Now, which of the following is true? Parcel A is heavier than parcel B. Parcel B is heavier than parcel A. There are two gas parcels of equal volume A and B at the same temperature and pressure. Parcel A is 1 mole of water vapor, 1 mole of H2O, while parcel B is 1 mole of dry air. Which of the following is true? Now the four options given are: parcel A is heavier than parcel B, parcel B is heavier than parcel A, both parcels are equally heavy, And without temperature and pressure data, their relative masses cannot be determined. Now we have to compare that what is heavier, 1 mole H2O or 1 mole dry air. 2H and 1O. And 1 mole dry air contain 78% of nitrogen, 20% of oxygen. Now here this will contain around 78% nitrogen. This nitrogen is heavier, oxygen is again heavier, these two are there, major component is these two, and these are heavier as compared to just oxygen. Therefore, this 1 mole of dry air shall be heavier than parcel A. Parcel B shall be heavier because it contains more amount of nitrogen, more amount of oxygen than the parcel A. This question, f of x sin x upon cos x, and then we have to find out what is sin x, we have to multiply that by cos x, and for variable values we have to find out the values, and this question appears tricky. It will take more time, I will have to work more on this concept, therefore I will not attempt, I will leave out this question. Again, this number, the number of three English letter words having at least one consonant but not having two consecutive consonants is at least one consonant. At least one consonant, two vowels are will be allowed, five vowels are there, but not having two consecutive consonants, then C and D is not allowed, F and G is not allowed, then no, this appears difficult, it cannot be solved within time by me, therefore I will leave it. A buys N copies of a book at 20% discount. B gets the same book at 30% discount. What is the minimum value of N for which B can buy one more book, one extra copy of the book, spending the same amount as A? Now, A has got 20% discount. Therefore, A will get the book at 80% of the cost. Cost of one book will be 80%, and he is buying N books. For B, 30% less means 70% cost, and within that cost V is buying N plus one more book. Then amount spent by A, 80 upon 100 N is equal to amount spent by B on the N plus one books. Therefore 70 upon 100 N plus 1. Then 100 is common, we'll cancel it out. That 0 is common, both were 80, 70, we can divide by 10, we can cancel those out. Therefore 8n will become 7n plus 1. Therefore 8n will become 7n plus 1, 7. When we solve it for n, 8n minus 7n is equal to 7. Therefore, n will become 7. And this is our answer. For 7 books, A will buy 7 books. B will buy 7 plus 1 books, 8 books. And their cost will be same. Therefore, minimum number of books or n is 7. This is the answer. A bird flies along the three sides of a field in the shape of an equilateral triangle at speeds 2, 4, 8 km per hour respectively. The average speed of the bird is. Now we'll draw equilateral triangle. It's a triangle with all sides equal. And let's that each side is A. Then bird will fly total distance. Total distance is equal to 3A. And bird is flying at, will fly this particular one side at speed 2 km, will fly 4 km, will fly the third side at 8 km per hour. Therefore, the time taken to travel this side is distance divided by speed. Therefore, time to travel first side is distance divided by 2. Time to travel second side is distance divided by a is the distance, a divided by 2. Third side, time taken to travel third side is a divided by speed is 8, therefore by speed. Now total time will be sum of these three times, a plus 4, a upon 8. Make the denominator equal, 4a plus 2a plus a is equal to 7a upon 8. Now total distance traveled, average speed, is equal to total distance traveled divided by total time taken. Total distance traveled is 3a, time taken is 7a upon 8. 8 is denominator of denominator, therefore it will go to numerator. 8 multiplied by 3a divided by 7a, a will be cancelled, therefore this will be 24 upon 7, and it's a speed, therefore unit is kilometer per hour, therefore the bird's average speed will be 24 upon 7 kilometer per hour. The average staff salary of a company is rupees 8000. A new guard and a new manager are recruited with salaries of rupees 5000 and rupees 20000. What is the current staff strength if the new average salary is 4000 more than that of the guard? Always read the problem carefully. This problem says that new average salary is 4000 more than that of the guard. New average salary is equal to 5000 is the guard's payment, and 4000 more than 5000, therefore this will become 9000. New average salary is 9000, and as average salary is 8000, for let's staff strength was X and average salary is 8000, therefore previous total salary was average salary multiplied by staff strength. Then new total salary will be this 8000x plus guard's salary, that is 5000, plus manager's salary, that is 20000. Therefore new average salary will be 8000x plus 25000. Now new staff strength will be, earlier it was X and now 2 employees added, 2. And because of this, new average salary will become 8000x plus 25000 divided by X plus 2. But new average salary, it is said that it is 9000, 4000 more than guard's salary. Therefore 9000 is equal to 8000 plus 25000. Now when we solve this for 8000x, when we solve this for X, the 25000 will come to this side, negative. Then now we will transfer 9000 to this side, and X will go to the multiplication to the left hand side. Therefore 9000 x plus 2 is equal to 8000 plus 25000. 9000x plus 18000 will become 8000x plus 25000. I will transfer x here and 8000x here and 18000x to the right hand side. Therefore, 9000x minus 8000x is equal to 25000 minus 18000. 1000x is equal to 7000 and 1000 will go away, x is equal to 7. Therefore, previous staff strength was 7 and 2 staff got added, therefore new staff strength will be 9. And we are asked, what is the current staff strength? Current staff strength is 9. This is the correct answer. This problem says that a 100 meter long fence is to be made by fixing a wire mesh on a steel pole. Each pole has 1 meter vertical portion and 1 meter portion tilted at 45 degree angle. Now such poles will be there to all the 100 meter distance. Now, vertical portion is 1 meter and tilted portion is 1 meter and wire mesh will have to be fixed on all this surface as well as this surface also. Therefore, total height of wire mesh will be 1 meter vertical plus 1 meter tilted portion. And wire mesh will be on this tilted portion also and wire mesh will be on the vertical portion also. Therefore, that wire mesh will be in the form of rectangle of 100 meter long plus 2 meter height. 1 meter vertical, 1 meter tilted one. Therefore, this wire mesh area will be 200 meter square. Therefore, 200 meter square is the answer. This problem appears tricky, but it is not. It says that DRPQ, DRQP is a small square of side A in the corner of a big square A, B, C, D. Of side A. This side is A. What is the ratio of the area of the quadrilateral PBRQ? PBRQ. Area of this quadrilateral has been asked. Now, what is the ratio of the area? Ratio is being asked. Ratio of this quadrilateral to the ratio of P quadrilateral PBRQ to the area of square ABCD. Now we will try to find out area of square ABCD. It's A square. But here it is said that A upon A is equal to, given is A upon A is equal to 3, means A is equal to 3A. Therefore A square will become 9. A square. Area of this whole big rectangle, big square is 9A square. Now, if we want to get area of this particular part, PBRQ, we have to subtract this triangle and this square from the ABCD. Therefore, area of this triangle will be, if this side is A, then this side, as we did calculated earlier, A is equal to 3A. If this is A, then this part will become 2A. For this, this is the square, therefore this angle C will be 90 degree. This is 90 degree right angle triangle. Area of right angle triangle is height in 1 half, height into base. Therefore 3A into 2A, 3A into 2A. Half will go, the area will be 3a square, this triangle. Area of this triangle is congruent to this because this side is again 2a, this is again 3a. Area will be same, that is 3a square. And area of this part will be a square. If you add this all, that area will become 3a square plus 3a square plus a square is equal to 7a square. Area of this part and this part. Now, to get area of these, we have to subtract 7a square from 9a square. 9a square is area of this whole square. 9a square minus 7a square is equal to 2a square. Area of this particular region will be 2a square. Now we are asked to find out ratio of area of this PBRQ, that is 2a square, to the area of this whole ABCD, that is 9a square. A square will get cancelled. 2 upon 9 will be the ratio, and 2 upon 9 is the answer.